Hey, this is Ray Dombrowski. If you've ever wondered how people make graphics with dot patterns or halftone patterns in Adobe Photoshop, I'll show you how. Let's go back a step, and here I've got my logo, and you'll notice it's got some gray in it. It's got a gradient, and this is very important when you're making halftone graphics, because when you make a halftone graphic, whatever's solid black will be solid black, and whatever solid white will be solid white, but whatever's in between the grayscale will be different size dots or line patterns. I'll just start with this logo, go Command A, Command C, and we want to create a new document, so Command N, hit OK, and then Command V, and this particular document is 1,000 by 1,000 pixels at 72 dpi. So if you've got a really high resolution image, you may need to use bigger dots. So let's go ahead and go image mode grayscale, and then click flatten, and then go image mode bitmap. And this image is 72 pixels per inch, and we do want to use halftone screen. So click OK. And here's where you select the number of lines or dots per inch, and also the angle, and also the shape of the halftone pattern. So real quick, let me show you the line pattern. Let's go 8 lines per inch at 45 degree angle. Hit OK. And you'll see how it makes a line pattern. That's pretty cool. Let's undo that and go back, image mode, bitmap, halftone screen again. Click OK, and this time let's choose round, which is one of my favorite halftone patterns. Let's go 12 lines per inch, and let's keep it at 45 degree angle. Hit OK, and you'll see how, since we chose so many more lines per inch, you'll notice how small the dots are. Let's undo that and go image mode, bitmap, halftone screen. Let's reduce that to 8 lines per inch, and let's do a 25 degree angle, and let's choose diamond as the shape. Click OK, and that looks pretty awesome. So let's go ahead, and this is a bitmap image, which is only black and white, and what we need to do is copy this thing back into our original document. So I'll go Command A to select all, Command C to copy, and then in our original document, let's open up channels. Let's make a new channel and just hit Command V to paste, and then Command click on that new channel. And what that does is you'll notice it selected everything that's white. And let's select inverse. So now it's selecting everything that's black. Let's create a new layer, hide that bottom layer, and just go edit, fill, and let's choose a color. Let's go with a blue, and then hit OK. And let's make a background color layer behind that. So Command A, select all, and then go edit, fill, and let's just choose a white, and go OK. And there you go, it's as easy as that. And you can follow that method and play around with it. I've also made a Photoshop action that'll automate this for you. And it may or may not work for you, just depending on the resolution of your image. But let me just show you that. Let's close that. And here I've got a rubber stamp image of my logo, and it's really blurry, but that's totally fine when you're making halftones. So below the video, I'll have a link to download this action. Just double click on it. That'll load it into your actions palette in Adobe Photoshop. And you're gonna wanna start with a flattened image. Then just click play on this make color halftones action. And then just let it do its thing. And I've made four different options, different resolution halftone patterns. This one's a line pattern. And that one's a diamond. These are round. And again, just click on the link below the video to download that action. Thanks a lot.